Oh, ik heb het nog schrijven. So this is it, eh?
Yes, it is.
The filming that must be filmed today. First of all, friends, welcome to the Patricius Brothers RC Aviation Channel. The channel where we will try to test as many different planes as possible. The channel when we don't edit nothing. And that is why sometimes the videos are crazy, but hey.
Yes. Who cares?
We still have the passion for DSA. And of course the channel when you can all feel at home, and that's the point, eh? Because the ultimate point of this channel is to show you that flying RC planes can be the best fun in life, and through this hobby you will get the best friends possible in the world.
Yes, yes.
So this is it. Now I will get to the story quick today. I won't babble too much because what is the point of today's filming? On today's filming we will show you how to set this beautiful and sexy Horizon Hobby E-Flight Ultimate 3D plane, the new release, to the NX6 new radio, the smart radio. Smart plane with a smart receiver and smart ESC with smart battery. We will plug it on the smart radio, and that's the point. Now, you have already seen the assembly of this plane. The assembly went together perfect. You can see, I mean, wherever you grab this plane, I mean, this is really just to hold it in your hands is amazing feeling. This plane is great. Now, of course, on the assembly video, you have seen that we have plugged this plane, so we have set it ourselves, the travels and everything. So we had the servos leveled. We have binded the plane with the radio, but that was not good bind. Now, of course, that bind was a simple bind that you don't have the safe select on. Then it was just the AS3X, which is good for almost all the pilots. But if you want to set yourself the safe on this plane, you must bind it in a way that I did, but I have just did one thing wrong, and that is you must bind it in the system setup. Now I will show you that. Of course, before you will do anything, you must take off the prop. Never bind and set your plane with the prop on, because
yeah, safety first.
Yeah, you never know what will happen, and the planes can bite your fingers and even cut your fingers off. We always say that
you don't have to unscrew it all the way.
Flying RC planes, these are not toys. So this is it. The first thing that you must do is to take off the prop. Now today I'm going to show you. You have two options, like I have said. The newspapers.
Postman, yes.
You can bind this plane in a way that you will have only the AS3X assist on, and that is only for the windy days. That compensates your move of the planes a little, so you fly more smoothly. In that way, if you want to have just that, you just put in the bind plug and bind it in the old-fashioned way. Of course, first you must set yourself the plane in the radio and then bind it, and just leave the bind plug inside. At the end of the binding process, you will have the plane bind with just AS3X.
Yes.
But if you want to use the safe select, which is perfect for some beginners, or if you get maybe sometimes even the experienced pilots can have some accident in the air, some sun glow or something that you're blinded for a second or two, at that time, you switch quickly on the safe select and it will level the plane, so you have that second or two to get yourself together and get the control of the plane again. Now I will show you how to do that. One version is you can push the button on the receiver, but the second one is that I always do is you can bind it with the plug. And now I will show you how to do that. Now first, of course, we will set the radio. I will come here, Captain Blush. You will show, I will turn the radio on. You can already see that we have the plane already here, but I will go in the system setup. I will go in the model utilities, delayed, and we don't have this model anymore. You can see here, we only have the Acro, and because I want to show you from the beginning to the end, because there is one thing, just film me quick. Read the instruction manual good, really good, because I didn't read it so good. There is one line inside, and because of that line, I didn't know how to bind this plane like it should be, and that is that in fact, we have been talking that on this radio. This radio is the sixth channel, but it has the seventh channel inside for the safe select. Mm-hmm. We have talked this because on usual sixth channel radios, if you want to put the select, you must risk one channel for that and you are left with just five channels. Now this one has the seventh channel for the safe, usually, but not on this plane, and that is what I didn't know. On this plane, the seventh channel is used for the reverse thrust. Because this plane is already set to be with the reverse, because it has the smart ESC inside. And that is why I was wrong. And now I will show you that today we will use the seventh channel, not for the safe, but for the reverse. And another channel we will use for the safe select. So this is it. And now I will show you from the beginning to the end.
Be a bit slower, because you're usually very fast.
And now I will go in the system setup. Yes, model select, add new model. Here, choose model type. You go here and you come to the bind and fly. How do you say?
Version.
Yeah, bind and fly, push the button and now push the create. And you will be sent here in the files that all the e-flight planes are already inside here, and the blades and the copters and all. Yes. And now you go to the e-flight ultimate, because we will take the advantage of this templates already inside. Now you have here the two versions. Now we must choose here today the version with the reverse, because this plane already has the reverse inside. I will just see if this one, no reverse, this one is not. Once again, I will go here, the second one is. The second one is with the reverse.
Yes.
Let's find it again. The ultimate, let's see. Uh-huh. Reverse. Now this one is with the reverse. Now I will choose this one. Import. We will wait a little.
Yeah, now it will go. Yeah, okay.
And now first I will set myself the audio level, so I will hear it better. You push this return button, do you see here?
Yes.
I will put it to 80, or maybe 85, so we will hear it. Confirm.
Volume 85.
Now you have already buttons assigned on this. I have shown you this on the previous video, but I will just show you quick that already you have the voices with the buttons. Listen to this.
Throttle cut on.
You have throttle cut here. You have the dual rates here. Listen.
Aileron, low rates. Aileron, high rates.
You have the gear.
Gear up. Gear down.
And of course you have
landing flaps. Normal mode.
Normal mode. So this is it. And now I will show you how to bind this. Now I will go back in the system. Now yesterday I was doing the crazy thing because I wanted to bind it. We then turn off radio and then turn it off and push the bind button, but that didn't work.
No.
I will just go now in the system. I will go in the system setup here. Yes. Now, once you go in the system setup, don't forget, always unplug your plane, because you see now that you don't have the signal anymore from the radio. In the system, you don't have this transmission anymore. Yes. I will go in the system setup and of course, I will go here in the bind, put it on bind, and of course now I will show you. I will take out the bind plug, which we have here, the extent for the binding.
Extension.
Extension. And the point is, like I have said on the previous videos, which Captain Blush thought that it's not true, but it is. If you want to bind yourself this in the safe select, I will now put the battery in. Once I hear the first voice, I will unplug the bind plug and then bind.
Uh-huh.
And then we will have the safe select. Are you ready, Captain Blush? Now you must be quick. And now unplug it. Uh-huh. And now go 3 meters away.
Yes, and when it is safe select, it will go through the surfaces twice.
If you have the safe select one, it will go to the surfaces twice. I will now unplug it, put like this. But now we have only the, we have the safe select on this plane. We still don't have the knob to switch the safe on and out. It is always on. So now I will show you. Now I was thinking myself, okay, for the seventh channel, I will use the safe, but on this plane not. You must use the reverse. And for that, I will use the gear channel. I will assign the gear, because we don't have the landing gear on this plane.
Yeah.
I will assign the gear channel switch to switch to the reverse. But first, you must go inside, of course. I have unplugged the battery, because you will see now, you have the light here. Do you see the light?
Yes.
At this point, the radio is giving the signal out. But once I will go in the system setup, you will see, it will, the light will turn off. It asks you, are you sure? Yes. Do you see?
Yes.
And now you don't have the signal. If I had the battery now plugged in the plane, the plane would go crazy or something. You never know. So you must always unplug it. And now I will go to the channel assignments. You see here only the six channels. Of course, I will go to the next. And you see here the seventh channel. Do you see it?
Yes.
But this time it will not be, it will not be for the safe, but for the reverse thrust. I will push button once and I will give this button for the seventh channel, and now I will go out. I will go here. When you see the monitor,
gear up, gear down.
Do you see now? And now I have the seventh channel here,
gear up, gear down,
for the reverse thrust.
Uh-huh.
And I will show you now the thrust first. We still don't have the safe select now, but reverse thrust. I will have to put the prop back. So you will see that we in fact do have now the reverse thrust on this plane, but we still don't have, do this with the filling so you don't break, because this is the aluminum and you don't want to break it. So I will go out like this, and you will see now that in fact I do have now the reverse. Just wait.
Uh-huh.
It has gone twice through the plane, the checking or the surfaces. If it goes twice, that means that you have the safe select. And if it goes just once, that means that you have the AS3S. Now I will come here, and now you will see. I will put it here, so we will see a little.
Yes.
Of course, we can now check the surfaces, and you already have now the double rates. But the rates are small now. Do you see this? They're not big, even in the high rates, because we still have the safe select on. You will see the difference. Show the travel. This is the maximum travel of the ailerons.
Uh-huh.
At this point, while we still have the safe select on. Now, at the point now is that I will show you the throttle. I will just, you see now,
yeah.
It goes in the reverse,
forward,
and now it goes to the reverse. Do you see this?
Yes.
And it can't be any other way on this channel. You must have the seventh channel for the throttle. And now I will put the throttle cut on.
And take off the prop.
No, I don't have to take off the prop, because I have the throttle cut. And now I will assign the safe select on. Now, first I will go here. I must check. I will go in the here in the monitor, and I will see. Aha, do you see this? I have this channel, the sixth channel. I have it here. So that means that I can assign this knob for the safe select, which I will. Now, how do you do that? Now, this is the point. You must put the throttle and the bow sticks down and towards yourself.
Yeah.
And then toggle five times this switch, and then it will assign. Now go and check the, watch the plane, if it will be okay. One. So this is it. Have you heard?
Yes.
Now I will unplug it once more, plug it in. Let's check.
Huh?
Throttle cut on, just in case. Now you will see that in fact, at this point, do you see?
Yes.
That we have slave select on because it wants to tilt the plane. And if I put the switch here, and now on the second stage, it has not assigned again. Wait. Maybe sometimes you have to do this twice. I will do it once more. Wait. I will do it once more. Like this.
Unplug it.
Unplug it. It should work now, eh?
Maybe you should put the switch all the way down, not in the middle.
All the way down? Yeah, I have put it all the way down.
If you put it in
check. Wait. Sometimes you have to do this more. This is...
Now leave it like this and then switch it.
Yeah. I can't.
Yeah, and then...
Can you switch it? Check.
Like this.
Ah, do you see it?
Now it's safe select. Now it's off.
Now it is off. You have the safe select on.
Yes.
On the first stage, on the second one you have this. You have only the AS3X, and on the third stage you have absolutely nothing. And that's it. And now you will see the difference. If I try to put the travels, do you see now? This is in the safe mode. Do you see the travels?
Yeah.
But once I will put in only AS3X, I mean, look at this, eh?
Much different, eh?
Then you must not be fooled, because these now are the full travels, and of course you have them, you already have set the triple rates. Do you see this?
Yes.
Now, you have the triple rates on three different knobs here. You have the rudder here, the ailerons here, and the elevator, you have them here. Now, if you want to put them all on the same button, I will just show you quickly. If you want to have them, of course, I will put the throttle cut on, because it is sometimes, and usually I set myself the radio that I have put the travels on one button. With one press of the switch,
yes.
I decrease or increase the rates with just one, switch.
It's not easier.
Yeah, it's not easier. You just go here, in the function list, press one, go in the expo and double rates, and you see here that you have the aileron on the switch F.
Yes.
So I will go to the aileron, I will put the elevator, go down, and just toggle this. The F switch, which I already have the ailerons on, and now I have the elevator here, confirm, go back, rudder, go down, press once, confirm, and now I have all the travels on just one switch.
Well, that's a lot easier.
And of course, if you don't want to listen to this, because now we have here, I will just show you one more thing, the reverse and forward thrust, I have it on the landing gear. Now, if you don't want to listen to this sound, you just go here, go out, go in the audio events, switch changes, gear up and down, push it, switch, uninhibited, and look at this. I don't have that annoying sound anymore telling me that the gear is up, because in fact I have this for the reverse thrust, and that's it, my friends. That's it. Now we have to film this, because like I have said, on this plane particular, because it has the reverse, on the usual planes it will not be the problem. On any other plane, you have seen that radio is already set for you, for the flaps, for the landing gears, for the throttle cut. So that means that on the ordinary plane, with the flaps and the wheels, this will be perfect already, and you don't have to worry, the seventh channel will be for the safe select.
Yes.
But in this case, and this is just one line in the instruction manual, and I didn't read it, so I had on the first attempt that I wanted to set myself a plane, I said I will put this to this knob, which has no assignment, but in fact, I had then the safe and the reverse on the same knob, and that could be a disaster. So be carefully, read all that you need, and like I have shown you, I will now go out from this, and by now, hey, this radio looks perfect to me. It works great. You already have inside here. I mean, you can do this on your own. You can set yourself a new model, put yourself a name, do the travels, everything. But it is all already done for you inside. And the point is that already you have all the travels set. You just check them if they're okay for you, and that's it. That is why it is good to use that those templates.
Yes, it's inside. Very comfortable.
Yeah. And the most important thing, my friends, if you want to set yourself the safe, this is the only way. Put the sticks down and towards inside and toggle whatever stick you want to be assigned to the safe 5 times full travel. 5 times 5, not more, 5. And then you will have that safe assigned to that. Not in, if you want to use the different one, just push the different one and it will be on different one.
That's it.
Now I hope that this was... I hope that this was
useful
for someone. Of course it was, because this was the way how to bind this with the new NX.
The correct way
with the new NX smart radio. Of course, Captain Bosch, just one more thing. Again, because this is the second time yours that we're filming this, we already made this video and I had the reverse and the safe on the same knob, so I won't show you that video. Of course, what I wanted to show, you know, Captain Blush, what I want to show. Just wait.
Yes.
Like this, the point is that I want just to show the viewers that in fact, show this, the information that you get from this now, from this plane, look at this.
Telemetry,
because now we have smart system and you can see now how much you have the power on the receiver, 6 volts. Do you see this?
Yes.
Then you have the information, do you see this? Of the battery.
Unscrew the propeller, so yeah. You will try the RPMs.
The battery, of course, I will unscrew the propeller quick. Wait.
When you will unscrew it, just tell me.
Yeah, I have the throttle cut.
Yeah, where is throttle cut?
This, on this side.
Throttle cut off.
Now you must go, no, go to the next one.
No, RPM is here.
Is it?
Yes. And this?
It's not here. It can't be, this is for the battery, Captain Blush. You can see the power, the beds temperature, you have the beds, you go one more. Look at this.
Uh-huh.
And now here you have the RPMs. Do you see this, eh? The RPMs and the throttle. How much of throttle do you have?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but do you know why is this?
Why?
Do you know why does it show already the 1000?
Because you have throttle cut on.
Yeah, because when I have plugged the radio on...
Unplug it.
I will unplug it again. Let's check this the second time. Leave it like this.
Nah, go out from this now.
Go out from this. Uh-huh.
Okay.
You have no information anymore. Because, but we were guessing this in the past. If it is okay that you have the throttle cut on when you turn on the radio.
Of course it's not good.
It must not be.
Yes.
Because you have seen that the radio thinks right now that when I plug the battery in, the motor already has 1400 RPMs, but it doesn't have. So this is it, and now I will show you. Plug it in once more. Wait.
Now it's
Let's
zero.
See. Do you see the information already?
Yes. Now this is it.
And now we have 0 RPMs. Do you see this, eh?
Yes. Never turn it on.
Yeah, now you can turn off. So we will see the reality. Do you see now?
Yes, 0.
And this is it, that is what we want to show you. You have the information about the temperature of the AC, the temperature of the battery, the rotations of this, and of course the voltage, the amps. So that means that now the best thing of this is that you will be able to put yourself the alarm on the...
And the good thing is,
the
good thing is that you will not have to buy any other sensors.
No, because this is
all integrated.
You already in the past you had the receivers and stuff to make yourself the telemetry, to get the temperature, the rotations and all. But all that you have to buy separately and it costs a lot of money. But with this, With this ESC, the battery, and with this receiver, you have it all. You don't need nothing. And all these informations can be also shown on the previous radios of this, of the DX. But of course, they must be upgraded, so they will show you that information in the bottom.
Yeah, this is
so this is Captain Mosh. Enough for today.
Yes. Half an hour window. Hey. And you said it's going to be
five minutes. 5 minutes. Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off for Slovenia. The beautiful and sexy ultimate plane with the setup on the NX radio. And now the only thing left is to test this on the runway. And I can't wait, because this will be something. I think that this will be one of the best flying biplanes by now, huh?
Yes.
Because it must be. It already looks so sexy that it must fly good. There's no other way here. So this is it. Well, friends, thanks again. Always been at home here and just expect more. We have a lot more to film and, well.
Yeah, that's it.
When we have the time, and that's it, eh? Thanks for all support again and stay safe and fly, click on something already, eh?